If buildings aren't loading in Fortnite for you, then you've come to the right place. I'm gonna show you how to fix the textures not loading or graphics not loading error in Fortnite. So make sure that you watch this video till the end if you want to know how to fix it. And let's start. The first step is to click on the search bar and type Device Manager. Now open the Device Manager control panel. And once you do that, what you want to do is go to Display Adapters, double click on your graphics card, so for me it's the GeForce GTX 1050, and once you do that, the properties should open up. Now go to Details, and under Property, what you want to do is select Hardware IDEs. Okay, so it's the third one from the top, click on it, and this should show up. Once you do that, click on the search bar again and type Registry Editor and open it. Once you open the Registry Editor, click on HK Local Machine, so click on the arrow next to it, click on System, click on Current Control Set, click on Enum, and now click on PCI, so click on the arrow. Okay, and now once you open it, what you want to do is find the first value in the properties for your graphics card in the registry editor. So for me it's VEN10DE, so I'm gonna try and find it. It's the second one. As you can see, the value is the same as the first one in the properties. And once you do that, click on the arrow next to it, so expand it once again, click on device parameters, click on Interrupt Management, and once you do that, right click on Interrupt Management and click on New and click on Key. Now name the new key Message Signaled Interrupt Properties. So Message Signaled Interrupt Properties and click on Enter. Now double click on the new key and this should open up. Now what you want to do is right click on the new key, so right click on Message Signaled Interrupt Properties, click on New and click on DWORD 32-bit value. Name the new key MSI Supported and click on Enter. Now double click on MSI Supported and set the value data to 1 and click on OK. You can now close the registry editor and the properties. The second step is to open the Epic Games Launcher. So right click, double click on it, click on the settings, scroll to the bottom of the page and click on Fortnite. Now click on additional command line arguments, and what you want to do is delete anything that is in the additional command line arguments box. If you have entered no texture streaming, then what you want to do is delete that, because as it says in this picture, texture streaming should improve performance, especially on lower end GPUs. The trade-off is that you might see some textures pop in right before your eyes. And it explains what it does. So it says, normally when you start a new level or reach a new area in a game, the game engine will load all textures used in this level or area into the graphics card memory. This is a good approach if the GPU has enough memory to keep all textures. However, if the texture quality is too high and there is not enough GPU memory, FPS will drop. Texture streaming is a different approach. Textures are loaded into GPU memory as needed. Objects in the level will have some placeholder blurry low resolution textures. Then, as the objects come into your view, the game will load higher resolution textures for them. This is a good approach when the GPU doesn't have much memory to work with. Pros of using texture streaming: better performance, especially on lower end GPUs. You may even be able to use higher texture quality without a significant performance hit. But there are also cons of using texture streaming, and those are: if textures aren't loaded quickly enough, you will see some textures pop in. So basically just delete the texture no texture streaming from the additional command line arguments, because it says that it is a trade-off. If you may get more FPS, but some textures may not get loaded in time. So just delete that. Once you delete that, or once you untick the additional command line arguments, you can close the Epic Games launcher. The third step is to click on the search bar and type system and open the system settings. Once you do that, click on advanced system settings and go to the advanced tab. Now click on settings under performance and click on adjust for best performance. Click on apply, and once you do that, don't close this window. What you want to do now is go to the advanced tab once again and click on change under virtual memory. Now untick the automatically manage paging file size for all drivers and tick the custom size. Enter your RAM memory in megabytes in initial size and maximum size. So for example, my laptop has 8 GB of RAM and that is 8000 megabytes, so I'm gonna enter 8000 in the initial size and 8000 in the maximum size. Click on set, click on OK, and click on OK again. Click on apply, click on OK, OK, and close the control panel. You can close the pop-up because you will restart your PC later. The fourth step is to click on the search bar and type device manager and open it. Click on the arrow next to display adapters and right click on the first graphics card. So for me, the first one is an Intel GPU, which is an integrated one. Right click on it and click on update driver. Click on search automatically for updated drivers. And if there are any new drivers that you need, then they will be automatically installed on your PC. Do the same step with the NVIDIA or AMD one. So right click on it, click on update, and click on search automatically for updated drivers. And once you update the drivers, you can close the device manager. I'm also gonna post the links for Intel, AMD or NVIDIA drivers in the description, so you can click on those and search for your driver manual. The fifth step is to click on the search bar and type edit power plan. Now open it, click on power options and select the ultimate performance or the high performance one. If you're using Windows 10 and if you don't see the ultimate performance, then I have a video on how to enable it. You can click on the card in the top right corner to check it out. And once you select ultimate or high performance, you can close the power options. The next step is to click on the search bar and type run. Now type %temp% and click on OK. And you can now click on Control plus A to select all of them and click on delete. Click on continue. And you can just skip the items that you need permission to delete. You can skip all of those. You can skip that one as well. And as you can see, all of the files except 3 are deleted. You don't have to worry about the files that aren't deleted because they are the ones that your computer needs at the moment. All of the other files are just temporary files that you don't need. And you can now close the temp folder. Now click on the search bar again, type run again, and type prefetch. Once you do that, click on OK, click on continue, and do the same thing again. So click on Control plus A to select all of them and click on delete. And you can just keep the files that won't delete. For the next step, what you want to do is click on the taskbar and open the task manager. You can also do that by typing task manager in the search bar and opening it. Now close any application that you don't need at the moment. So for example, I don't need the calculator. I don't need this one as well. You don't need the Epic Games launcher while you're playing Fortnite, so you can just end it. You don't need Microsoft Edge. I don't need movies and TV or the Microsoft Store or the Skype. And what you want to do is just close any application that you don't need at the moment that is just taking up memory and disk memory while you're playing Fortnite. and you can close the task manager. And the next step, what you want to do is open Fortnite, and once you open it, go to the settings in-game, go to the video settings, and put the frame rate limit to 60 FPS or 120 FPS, depending on what are you getting in-game. So I'm gonna set it at 120 FPS, lower the 3D resolution to around 60%, put the view distance to near, turn off the shadows, turn off anti-aliasing, put the textures, effects and post-processing to low, turn off vSync, turn off motion blur, and turn on allow multi-threaded rendering. Once you do that, click on apply and exit the settings. And the final step is to set Fortnite to high priority, and you can do that by clicking on the card in the top right corner, which is my ultimate FPS boost guide and how to get 300 and plus FPS in Fortnite on any PC. So click on the card and do all of the steps in that video, and you should be getting more FPS, and also the textures or graphics error should be fixed. Thanks for watching, please subscribe, like and comment.